with everything that makes a young man a star. Oh, you were a star. And I was there, and I swear to God, now my mother's grave on everything I have.
Hold on to your hat.
The music knows souls.
We become enraptured.
Alcoholism within a family is like a tornado. You never know what the next storm will bring. Many family members react with fear, some with grief, and others with anger. But unlike a tornado, this is a storm that rages inside the home. There's help in Al-Anon, a mutual support group for families and friends affected by alcoholism. If you're concerned about someone else's drinking, call Al-Anon today, 1-888-4-Al-Anon. Al-Anon, we're here to help.
Hi, this is Jimmy Ray. I just want to say a big hi and a big thank you to all my friends and fans at the Music Mill. I'd love to come and meet you all individually, one by one. So send your phone number in and your address. I'll see you next week.
And just how much training did you have to prepare you for a career in this contemporary music business?
I started young because my family was so musical, and we didn't really listen much to records or radio or watch much TV, which made me feel a little isolated when I was young, but now I really appreciate that because it forced me to look inside for inspiration and look inside for music. And we were always making music in the home, so it started young, started it with my parents. And then I remember hearing Annie Lennox's voice and stopping in my tracks. Wow, what a gorgeous old soul voice that is. And I think she helped lead me into more Black American music because she's so inflected vocally with Black American influence. So that led me into studying jazz. I went to Berklee College of Music. And I was always kind of an overachiever anyway, so I knew I had to go to college. So I went to college for music, and I was from this little Yankee white town, Rockport, Massachusetts. And I liked Berklee because it was so eclectic. There was so much of the world there, all different ages, races, cultures. And it was more like the world instead of another high school. And therefore, I was able to kind of test the waters and perform more and become less shy. I used to be so shy. I'd have my eyes shut the entire performance, sometimes with my back turned. So I studied jazz. I was one of the only white girls in the gospel choir there, and R&B, soul. Then I got influenced a little bit by Hounds of Love, Kate Bush, and Peter Gabriel's So record that started me into writing. I think everybody, you know, has their own unique path, because mine was pretty different. And it's really up to the individual to look within and find strength, inner strength, and find that confidence and that courage to make their own path. That's what makes an exciting, original vision anyway, is making their own vision, not relying heavily upon external influence or contemporary music even.
Right. If I were to ask you today, now that you're well into your career, what do you find yourself learning about today now that you're in the business, doing things like this about publicity and the different things that occur on the tour? What are you learning about today?
Wow, I feel I've come so far, and I've had to learn so much. First about music, then about the studio, making records, and then about the business, being present for my record, negotiating for the contract, and now it's a lot about patience, gratefulness, gratitude and thankfulness for each day, never to become too inflated, for my ego to become too inflated, or to even really believe what all the media says about me, whether it's bad or good. I have to endure a lot. My body has to endure a lot because the schedule is so incredibly hectic when you get successful, and anybody that has success complains about it. So I just have to remember to breathe and remember that this is my moment. This is my moment to lay a foundation that will hopefully last for a decade or two, because I plan to make records until I'm old, and remain humble enough to be grateful. Be thankful for being here now.
If you had to choose the one tool that you're still using today in your career from your early training and education, what tool would that be and why?
I'd say most dramatically was touring with Peter Gabriel, because I hadn't toured for several years. I mean, I'd never toured. I hadn't performed for several years since college. And he heard my first record, and although it wasn't released, he asked me to sing with him, and suddenly this lonely little songwriter who was shut up in her bedroom all the time was thrown out in front of 16,000 Germans after one rehearsal and had to do show, and was put up in 5-star hotels, and it was the big rock tour. And I really didn't get very much guidance at all from anybody on the tour. It was really about me figuring it out fast for myself. And it forced me to become more mature, more professional, more self-reliant, less shy, more courageous. So that really slapped me into form pretty quickly. It had to, or else I would have perished.
Training? Yeah. No, I can't think of anything. I think it's just playing live, I think really does it. If you have to get a band together or do something, or do it by yourself or whatever, but get out there and realize, I think when you get in front of people, then you understand what you're doing wrong. And it makes you, it gives you the incentive. Then you really, it scares you so much that you either will quit or keep going and get better at it.
What do you find yourself being educated on today, this far along in your career? What are the things you're learning about today as you're out touring? And is there anything new to be learned after this long in the music business?
There probably is. I don't think I'll learn that.
Whoever has 24 bands in 9 hours is out of their mind. But that's all right. That's what this business is about. It's like, I like the fact that it's kind of, there's a lot of people that are here. Some people are starting out. Some people have been around here for a long time. And I think having that many bands, I think it's cool. Because everybody seems pretty cool. Nobody's like real nasty. I think if they had egos, they left them, there's no door because it's outdoors.
If there's one tool from your early education, whatever that was, whether it was just learning the ropes, doing the tours, if there's one tool you still use today, which would that be?
I don't know.
I'd say listening a lot. You know, it's the old thing, you know, what's the best kind of interviewer, what's the best kind of interviewee? It's a guy that listens, you know, so, you know, the more you can listen to, you know, if you're closed-minded, if you don't listen to, Tom listens to more different kinds of music than I do, and you know, he introduces me to stuff, and he knows the difference between something real good to play for me and something real bad, but his wallet's the thing that hurts more than his ears, because he buys so much stuff that's like, how many records do you buy a week? You buy
10. I should write those off, right? But it's too complicated.
It's real easy to figure out. If you got 10, I'd say write them off, because it's, you know, that's the business kind of stuff of it. But yeah, just listening. You got to listen, and you got to watch. You got to see what everybody else is doing, and you know, and don't do something that you don't feel comfortable with, and don't feel you have to jump in and do something that just because everybody else is doing it. That, you know, that's. That's peer pressure, like you get mocked like in junior high school, grade school, and high school. So why the heck would you do it here? And that's one thing that I think the cheap trick. It's like, you know, we never tried to be anybody else, and we never tried to go with what's the next new thing, because we knew we'd never be the next new thing. So, you know, it's like, cool. And then we stuck around, and here we are.
Hold on to that guitar. The Music Mill Source will be right back.
Alcoholism within a family is like a tornado. You never know what the next storm will bring. Many family members react with fear, some with grief, and others with anger. But unlike a tornado, this is a storm that rages inside the home. There's help in Alateen, a mutual support group for young people affected by alcoholism. If you're concerned about someone else's drinking, call Alateen today. 1-888-425-2666. Alateen, we're here to help.
Hi, I'm Paula Cole, and we're here on the Music Mill.
Now, the Music Mill Rehearsal Complex has been a great catalyst for the show, and remains the home of many of New England's local premier bands and musicians, providing them a steady place to rehearse. Stay tuned, because later we'll be displaying the information line where you too can find out more about the rehearsal complex or anything else you've seen on the show.
Cold and wet. reeks of beer. The lights are turned out permanently, but that's okay, 'cause I don't want to.
Musical training and education, and okay. If you can think back to the early days, what kind of training did you have to set you up for a career in this business?
Well, I mean, I started playing guitar when I was about 5 years old, just taking normal guitar lessons and stuff, and I became pretty obsessed with instrument, and I also played some piano and some keyboards because my grandmother is a pianist, and when I was 12 and 13 and 14, I went to like music camp in the summers. And there are a lot of kind of like serious muso guys there, like a little bit older than me, and they kind of got me into weird chord voicings and all that kind of stuff. So that was a good experience, and they kind of got me into like English prog rock and really arty music, that kind of expanded my horizons a little bit. And then all through high school and college, I took some, you know, like theory courses and stuff like that. So like my theory and my knowledge of like harmony is quite good, and also technically, of course, a lot of electronic music courses and all that. I know the gear really well. Like, my sight reading is atrocious, unfortunately, and I need to work on that. But I do, you know, I have this kind of weirdly uneven musical education.
And could you describe for us the type of things that you're learning about now, in an established music career? Mm. How does that differ from, let's say, your basic foundation training? What are you learning about now on the road or in the studio?
Well, what's interesting is that in a live situation, you know, so many subtleties get lost that you almost need to kind of communicate essences as opposed to minute details, where in the recording process, you know, you've got microphones that are right on you and it hears every little thing, and so that's the way that I'm used to working. I'm typically used to working that way. So you know, in a live situation, it's a totally different animal, and it's a process I'm going through, learning how to deal with that and communicating large essences of the song as opposed to kind of being really intimate and subtle and quiet. So you know, that's been the main difference in terms of playing music as a career, you know, where kind of the details unfortunately get a little bit lost. And hopefully you get to a point where, you know, everybody gets good enough at what they're doing that you can show the details and show that part of what you're doing. But, you know, in a way, in the beginning, you just like play the song, get it out there, make sure the melody's clear, make sure the chords are there, and that's that.
Hey, what's going on? I'm Teddy Geiger, and you're watching The Music Mill, where they mill music into products that you can use in your everyday life.
Hi, this is Ayla Brown, and you're watching The Music Mill.
Many of the theme songs for this television program were written and produced by Peter Keyes Berwin, who writes songs before they become hits for the commercial music industry. Now with over 400 songs in catalog unpublished and available, stream Peter Keyes Berwin music at any of the websites shown on the screen.
This program was partially produced in cooperation with the New England Music Mill Rehearsal Complex, the home of many of New England's premier bands and musicians. For band and musician rehearsal space, contact the phone number or website shown on the screen.